Hello everyone, welcome to the first Frequently Asked Questions video. I've gotten a lot of questions and I appreciate all the comments and responses that were left on the other video and on Facebook and also to the email address. So let's get started. All right, number one, how much did the entire project cost and how long before you get a return on your investment? That's sort of a tricky question. Basically, the dome cost about $45,000 to build. That included the excavation work, all the materials for the building, the solar system, parts for the rocket mass heater, all the grow beds and whatnot. The return on investment is a little bit trickier to calculate. The dome is used for personal production of vegetables, so we don't sell that, so you can offset some of that cost just by not having to purchase groceries. And it's also used for testing some of my electronic equipment that I've been developing, so that's also very difficult to calculate. But overall, it's about 10 to 12 years for payback, mostly paid off of the vegetable production and also from the ad revenue from these YouTube videos. So you watching is always very helpful, and thank you. Okay, number two. Why are some people growing on rafts instead of media, and what are the differences? There are some differences. It's very easy to grow leafy vegetables in the raft systems, like lettuce, spinach. They have a much smaller root structure and they can really handle having their roots wet most of the time. Growing in a media system, I grow using expanded shale. It works really well with larger plants such as tomatoes and cucumbers. The roots can spread out into the media pretty far and anchor themselves right in. And I also like to use the media. It's used for helping to aerate the water. As the water levels rises and falls through the system, that air is getting sucked in and out of the media and is absorbing into the water, so it helps out a lot. Okay, number three. I'm also curious about your motivations in taking on this project. Was it for self-sufficiency as a testbed for your electronics? Yeah, it's a little bit of each. Self-sufficiency is always a great thing where you don't have to rely on the large corporate farmers for your fruits and vegetables. And it really does help to offset some of your costs. Getting fresh fruits and vegetables, the tomatoes and the lettuce, is really a huge difference between buying the commercial things that have been packed in a truck and shipped across the U.S. A lot of tomatoes are usually picked green and then shipped and they ripen in the truck. So you really start losing a lot of that flavor. And they're a much tougher breed. I grow heirloom tomatoes. These are Amish paste. They're very, very tender. They're easy to cut up. Very, very tasty tomatoes. I also do use it for electronics. I also help to share some of this information out with other people, do some little bit of training, and this year we're going to start doing some more formalized tours and education with the greenhouse. Okay, number four. Do you filter your raft system somehow, or does your media bed system act as a filter? The media beds are acting as a filter. I have it set up so that I have a media bed set up higher than the raft system, and that then drains into the raft. I'm starting to find that I'm getting enough aeration in the water where I don't have to put air stones in with the rafts at all. So that's helping to save a lot of money with electricity by not having to pump air through the system. So that's very beneficial. Inside of all the media beds, I do have red wiggler worms that are used for helping to degrade the fish waste that gets into the beds. So it's basically a very complete ecosystem where you have the fish solids going into the beds, the worms break it down, the nutrients are in that bed, it then flushes into the raft beds and then back into the fish tank. Number five, who are your favorite YouTubers? Well, I have a few. Primarily, I enjoy the Paul Wheaton 12 channel. He runs the permies.com website. It's a nice forum for people that want to work on permaculture, and they cover a lot of different things on permaculture, rocket mass heaters, and sustainability. So he has a pretty good website and has some pretty entertaining videos that he puts out. I also enjoy the Smarter Everyday channel, which is Destin WS2. And I'll put links to these down below in the comments or in the video. He has a really good channel where he goes and analyzes all kinds of different things. Probably my favorite so far has been the helicopters and how they operate. It was very educational and entertaining at the same time. And then lastly, more of an entertainment site is the Slow Mo Guys. However, there's a lot to learn with that by watching some of their videos in their slow mo, where you can see some of the physics behind different things between fire, filling water balloons and whatnot. So I also enjoy watching that. So that's our first five questions. I appreciate the questions coming in. And if you have more questions, feel free to leave them in the comment for this video, or you can send me an email at faq@bigelowbrook.com. And if you do find these videos to be educational, we always would appreciate a donation. There's a link also provided in the video, and that is used for helping to fund the greenhouse and some of these experiments that I work on. Okay, well, thanks for watching.